A mother squash bee emerges into the pre-dawn sky, leaving her underground burrow with a busy morning ahead of her. The squash and pumpkin flowers she feeds on are only open early in the day. She drinks their nectar and collects pollen from male flowers, holding it on her hairy hind legs. She visits flower after flower, in doing so moving pollen to female flowers and fertilizing the plants. Returning to her burrow, she bypasses the small rest chamber near the surface. Now is no time for a nap. She has offspring to provide for. In cells branching off from the main tunnel, she forms masses of pollen for her future offspring. Each mass, or pollen provision, takes multiple trips to complete. She then lays an egg onto the pollen provision and closes off the tunnel to the cell as she departs. Unlike social honey and bumblebees, squash bees are solitary and care for all their offspring on their own. A few days later, the egg hatches and the new larva begins to feed, gradually growing in size until it fills the cell. Then it will empty its guts and spin a cocoon, inside which it will enter an inactive state and wait out the winter. Meanwhile, the pollinated flowers develop into squash and pumpkins, just in time for Halloween and Thanksgiving festivities. Squash bees are some of the most efficient pollinators of these flowers, helping support an industry worth $320 million in the United States alone. As they are wild species, they don't require direct management by farmers. However, use of chemical pesticides as well as heavy tillage that destroys burrows can reduce squash bee populations and jeopardize the service they provide. When summer comes again, the adult bees emerge, digging their way up and out of the soil, where they too will feed, mate, pollinate, and build burrows of their own, continuing their life cycle as well as the squash plants year after year.